Good morning, my dear students. This video is made especially for students of Middle 3. Today we are going to do a revision on Unit 1, the grammar, the recorded speech, as you know. So please, if you'd like to open your booklet, no problem. If you'd like to watch the video without opening, no problem, and work with me, okay? First, we are going to start by answering the quiz question. We are going to do or answer about 10 sentences. Rewrite the following sentences using the words in brackets to give the same meaning. Okay, number one, it's been recorded that aliens from outer space were seen in this town last week, he said. Okay, so the answer would be, he said that it has been, not it has been, it has been recorded that aliens from outer space had been seen, not were seen, in that town, and the last week is going to be the previous week or the week before. Okay, sentence number two. I work in a chocolate factory, Paul said that, because Paul is a boy, so we are going to change I into he. Paul said that he worked, the past symbol of worked in a chocolate factory. So the answer, Paul said that he worked in a chocolate factory. Sentence number three. The sentence says, I've already done my homework, said the pupil. In this sentence, we have the word pupil. The word pupil is like a student, and we don't know if it can be a boy or a girl. So you have two options here. We can say that the pupil said that he, okay, if it's a boy. Or you can say that the pupil said that she is also correct. So the pupil said that he have is gonna be had, he had already done. My homework should be changed to his homework if the pupil is a boy, and her homework if the pupil is a girl. So the pupil said that he had already done his homework, or the pupil said that she had already done her homework. Sentence number four. The sentence says, you must be here by 10, son, said my dad. My dad told me I must can be changed into had to, or you can leave it as must, but change it into had to is better. I had to be there by 10. There, here, should be changed to there. Again, the sentence, my dad told me I had to be there by 10. Sentence number five, I'm doing my homework now, Noha, said Ola. So, this is a dialogue between Ola and Noha. The answer is, Ola told Noha that she was doing her homework then. She was doing her homework then. Okay, so am doing, present continuous, should be changed to past continuous, and my should be changed to her because the speaker is a girl, and the noun should be changed to then as you memorize. Sentence number 6 says, you didn't tell me what happened the last week, Bob, said Sarah. So Sarah told Bob that he, exactly you means Bob, he didn't tell me should be hadn't told her. So we go back, we go one step back with the tense, so the past symbol should be changed into the past perfect. Sarah told Bob that he hadn't told him, her, told her, me, refers to Sarah. So Sarah told Bob that he hadn't told her what had happened the week before, or the previous week. Sentence number 7. My father drives fast, said Ali. Ali said that his father drove fast. Sentence number 8. You're wasting my time today, daughter, said my mother. My mother told her daughter that she's wasting her time that day. Today should be changed to that day. Sentence number 9. I always do my duty, said the worker. The worker said that he always did his duty, or she always did her duty if the worker is a man or a woman. The last sentence, sentence number 10. Here is a paper for you, Ahmed, said the teacher. Ahmed, the teacher, said that there was a paper for him. Okay? Now let's turn the page and let's move to another part, which is the reported question. Don't forget that we have two types of questions. We have yes, no question and the WH question. Okay? In yes, no question, we use if or whether instead of the quotation marks. Okay? And in the WH questions, we drop the quotation marks and use the WH word. For example, sentence number 1, what are you doing next Saturday, Susan, said her friend. Susan's friend asked her what she was doing the following Saturday. So the most important part, that after the question mark, the order should be subject plus verb. Okay, as we said, Susan's friend asked her what she was doing. She was, not what was she doing. Okay? Sentence number 2. What did your dad bring you on your holiday, Sally? I said, so I asked Sally what her dad had brought her on her birthday. Sentence number 3, is your brother coming from Canada today? This is yes, no question. Let's see what happens in the yes, no question. He said, okay, so he asked if his brother was coming from Canada that day. He asked, we can say, he asked her if her brother was coming from Canada that day, or he asked him if his brother was coming from Canada that day. Sentence number 4, my father said, where have you been, daughter? My father asked where his daughter had Then, number five, have you seen this film before, Anne? Nagi asked. Nagi asked if Anne had seen that film before. Sentence six, I said to Rami, what color do you prefer? I asked Rami what color he preferred. Okay, what color he preferred. You can notice that in the yes no question, if we have a helping verb like do, does, and did, we just omit, drop. We don't use do, does, or did, and we return or get the verb one step back. What does your father do, Tom? Said Sandra. Sandra asked Tom what his father did. What his father did. Drop does and change do into the past. So she asked Tom what his father did. Can you notice that the order after the WH word is subject, then comes the verb. In sentence number 8, she said, where do you live? She asked where I lived. Or she asked where he lived. Or she asked where she lived. Okay, because we don't know the subject of you. It can have many possibilities. Sentence number 9. Dad said, where did you leave your bike yesterday, Steve? Dad asked Steve, where? Okay, tell me, where left he or where he left? Very good, where he left his bike and yesterday should be changed into the day before or the previous day. Sentence number 10, can you give me a hand, Sarah? Said Anne. Anne asked Sarah if she could give her a hand. If she could give her a hand. So this is the end of this video. Okay, in the next video, inshallah, we are going to answer the command. See you. Bye.